So now we want to talk a little further about objects. Objects are used all over the place in programming. And so while it's kind of a new, idea now for us, it'll, as we progress throughout programming, this is just seen all over the place. And as I'm trying to think of examples of things I can do to demonstrate these principles, they're really hard. It's a lot of pressure to try and come up with good stuff. And I know what you're saying, which is, that was good stuff? Well, yeah, no. Eventually, you just get to a point where it's like, okay, I have to do something, so I'll just do this example, and hopefully it's not too boring. So I've thought about how to demonstrate this thing. I know that many of us like to sit down and play some video games, right? And one of my all-time favorite video games is StarCraft. And I love the game. I love the concept of creating these armies and trying to get resources and the strategy involved and everything. So that's a great game, right? Well, all of these games like this use instances of objects to accomplish the tasks that they're trying to accomplish, right? And so to kind of demonstrate this, the most basic object in StarCraft is, if you're the Terran race, is a Marine. That's kind of the most basic object you build. Well, I guess even more basic than that is the SCVs that do all the mining, right? But let's look at the Marine for a second. So the way that the game works, now we can't actually use StarCraft because that would violate all sorts of copyright stuff. So I'm going to create a game called Mooncraft. Okay, so this will be my Mooncraft game. And in the Mooncraft game, I'm going to have, I can't have a Marine, so I'm going to have, how about in honor of my dad who was in the Navy, we'll do a Navy personnel. So it will be a sailor. This will be a sailor that we're going to build here. And so this is going to be the object, okay? Now picture this is going to be going into the game. So I'll create a new Java program, and the name of this object is going to be a sailor. So public class sailor, okay? This is the template for the sailor object that's going to be created. Every time I create a new sailor, this is what's going to be created. Now, the very first thing that we'll notice about any soldier in this video game is they're going to have some things in common, right? So we're going to have a, for example, a sailor might have energy, okay? And so I'm going to create this, and we'll just make it an integer that's going to be energy, and we'll set the initial energy of this sailor to be 100, let's say. Okay. Then we can, what else do we have? Well, we need to have an X and Y position so we can keep track of where the sailor is on the screen, right? And so we can create an X and set the default equal to, let's say we've got a, 600 by 600 screen. So we'll set the default to, that's a small screen. Let's do 1,000 by 1,000. So the default will be 500, and we'll just put them right dead center. So the initial position of that sailor, the X and Y position, is going to be 500. Okay, so now we've got this sailor object, and it's got these variables to keep track of it. Now, based on our discussion about scope, who can see this information? Well, it's between this brace and this brace, so any method in the class can get at these variables. And this is all we need to start an object, okay? So let me go ahead and I'll save this. Save the sailor object, compile it to make sure it works. And let me go ahead then and build a new object. So public class, and this will be the actual game itself. So this is our Mooncraft game, has nothing to do whatsoever with StarCraft. And this will be our driver, so this will have the main method. So public static void main string args. Okay. And then I can create now an instance of that object by saying I want a sailor object that I'll just refer to as S1. And I want to set that equal to a new instance of a sailor object. Okay? Now that I have that sailor object, I can take, for example, and say, let's set S1's X position equal to, instead of being 500, I'll set it equal to 250. And so it'll be, that's the X position, the Y position will be the same. So let me just test this out by saying system.out.println S1.x, and maybe to keep track of it, I'll say X and then concatenate on S1.x. And then system.out.println, I'll print the Y and concatenate on S1.y. Okay? So this X variable belongs to the S1 object I've created. Now we have to keep in mind that's not the sailor object itself. It is an instance of the sailor object. So based on this template, it's created an object that it's now referring to in memory as S1. And if I take and run this little program here, then I can see that my X is now 250, my Y is 500. The only problem is this. I said my game board is going to be 1,000 by 1,000, right? What happens if I set this X's variable to be 1,500? Well, the problem is that it's set equal to 1,500. There's no check for it. This is kind of like, you know, you're out to eat with somebody, a friend, and if they were to just take and reach on your plate and grab some food and eat it, how would you feel about that? You know, I can probably get away with that with my wife, but if just, you know, a person walking by, let's say, what if a person walking by just walks by and grabs something off your plate and eats it? That's kind of not cool, right? In just the rules of our society, that's not a cool thing to do. We have kind of rules and manners and all that kind of stuff. Now, if you're out to eat with a friend and you say, oh man, that thing looks good, then a lot of times, especially if you say it enough, I've found, then they'll say, would you like to try some? Well, as soon as they've said that, there's an invitation to do it, right? And so then you can take a bite and there's nothing awkward about it if they've offered and you say, man, I really would like to try that, see if it's any good. And then, you know, do you want to try a bite of mine? You know, try and return the favor. The thing about object-oriented programming is we don't like people reaching into our object and setting stuff. We do need a way for them to set stuff, but we want them to ask us, not so that we can control it, right? We can control whether that's bigger or smaller than the game board. And so what I'm going to do is change this up a little bit, all right? I am going to make these variables private, meaning only inside this class can I access these variables, right? If I compile that and then come back to my Mooncraft game, then it will now say that has private access. You can't just reach into my plate and mess with it. Well, okay, fine. That's fine. But I need a way to be able to set the X and Y coordinates if I'm controlling the game, right? If the user presses up, I have to be able to change the coordinate on the screen and paint the little graphic to make it do what it's supposed to do and be placed on the game where it's supposed to be placed, right? And so what we do instead is this. Now, it's not just this one. If I take out this line, I'm still going to get bugged over even trying to read the variables because they have private access. They only belong to the sailor object. And so I can't even do this stuff. Well, but if I need to be able to print out the energy to update the screen to say how much energy, that particular soldier that I've clicked on has, then I need a way to be able to do that. And so what we do is we create what's really common in programming, something called getters and setters. In fact, in other languages, when you create variables like this, you can just say, create getters and setters, and it'll do it for you. But basically, it's this. We're going to create a method to be able to set the energy and one to be able to get the energy. Two different methods, and we're going to do one that for energy, one of each for the X, and one of each for the Y. Now, these methods are going to be public because we do want them to be able to use these methods. We want other classes to be able to tie in and use these methods. So I'll say public, and this is the setting method, so set energy. So we don't need to return anything. It'll be void, but this will be called set energy. Okay, and if they're going to set the energy, do they need to pass something in? Yeah, they do. And so I can say int, and then just call it whatever I want to call it. So pass in the energy that you want to be creating. Well, the problem is that I've already got a variable there named energy. And we're going to find out this isn't really a problem. I can do this because I can. What we end up doing is doing this. I can say set this dot energy, meaning some of this stuff's really hard to explain. This refers to this controlling object. So go into this particular sailor object and set the energy of the object equal to the energy that was passed in. Now this was done so that we could use this same name. We didn't have to get creative with our naming. But this will set the object's energy equal to whatever energy just came in through these parentheses. And so we use this keyword in this type of a situation to refer to not the energy here, but the energy of the object. Okay? But if that's confusing to you, we can just say set, we can call this E, and then just do this. Okay, but we actually want to do a little check first because, never mind, that's on the X and Y coordinates. So this is all we're doing here, is setting the energy, right? So then I can create a getter, which just means I can get the energy. So public, now is this going to need to return something? Yeah, it's going to return the energy. So I'm going to need to return an int, and this is going to be called get energy. And it's not going to be passed in anything, it's only going to return something. So then I can say, when the user calls this method, then I want to return the energy of the object. So this energy. Okay? So I compile that, and now in my Mooncraft object, I can say go to that S1 object and call the set energy method. And pass it an 80. Okay? And then after I've done that, then I can go and print out using the s1.getEnergy method. Okay, so I set the energy there, I pass it the amount, I get the energy here, which is going to be in the middle of a print statement, so it'll print it out. And now if I run this program, it will print out the energy of that object. And it did it in a nice, pleasant way. Nobody was reaching on anybody else's plates to get stuff. I gave them a method saying, you can ask me, and I might give it to you. So that's the option that I give them. And then I get the energy using that same polite way. Okay? All right, hopefully this is making sense. We'll kind of continue this discussion in the next video. Spencer out.